Hi, my name's Ian Van Tuyl, and this is the video walkthrough for the 2011 Jeanneau 57. This particular vessel is located in Marina Del Rey, California, and has just came on the market. This is a stunning yacht. We have a majestic blue hull. This is an all-grip hull. We also have snow-white boot stripes and a snow-white cove stripe. I mean, the attention to detail on this paint job is just outstanding. As we look back, you can see the teak decks and a really nice boarding from the side of the vessel. The Dodger itself, this is a custom Dodger. The Dodger has a stratoglass stainless steel handles. It also is convertible, so this aft bow will fold up and have a really nice windshield kind of protecting your cockpit, but also lets a lot of that natural light in. The bimini itself does the same. It will fold back, and then there's also a connector from the aft side of the Dodger to the forward part of the bimini. Stepping aboard the vessel, you can see really nice wide side decks, stainless steel handles, everything. Everything's led back to the cockpit, making this Jeanneau 57 a very easy boat to single hand. The rigging itself is quite spectacular. This is a diaphragm standing rigging. And the way you can tell that, I don't know if the camera angle will allow you, but they have flat edges on it. So this rigging, it gives you the strength of rod rigging. Very, very high-end upgraded rigging. We had a custom forward deck pad built as well. And then as you can see all the way up forward, a really nice size Lumar windlass, double bow pulpit here for double anchors. We have the electric Facnor furling system, and then also the attachment eye for a tack line. This vessel is kept in just pristine condition, as I mentioned. The teak is in just superb condition. The tow rails are highly varnished. Everything on this vessel is as it was when we delivered it to the owner. Looking aft, you're going to see we have a large cockpit. The cockpit itself has all custom cockpit cushions and pads, very thick, making it a real comfortable cockpit to be in. You can see here the table itself. This has been all taken apart and sent into a spray shop where they have urethane spray. I think there's about like 12 to 16 coats, you know, on this table, making it almost like a piano finish. Just stunning. We have our Jeanneau winches and then our main sheet winches back as well. Those are both electric and they're both controlled by switch controllers right here. So when you're at the helm, if you want to adjust the main by pulling it in, you have a fast and slow speed. And if you want to adjust the Jeanneau, you have a fast and slow speed here as well. We have the main sheet clutch. So both sails can be handled and operated from both helms, making it very nice. We have our VHF ram mic, our quick controller, bow thruster, our furling in and out. Then you can see here we have all of our cockpit lights, instrumentation. This is the Raymarine ST70. And then we have the autopilot. Centrally located is the C140 chart plotter. This is also in a scan strut sealed pod. And then at the port helm, we have our instrument controls here as well too. Also compass and dual controls for the electric winches. The Jeanneau 57 possesses all of the mega yacht systems on it. So from the plumbing to the electrical, these are all 24 volt winches. You know, everything on this yacht is of yacht quality. As we come down below the vessel, you're going to see a very nice large companionway that opens up here. It actually is counterbalanced and it slides, making it really nice. We have a gradual step coming down into the salon. The salon itself is really inviting. Light and natural. The cushions themselves, this is a kind of a beige leather. So this is an upgraded leather that we had ordered in. The nav station itself is very convenient. Lots of storage below, behind it for foul weather gear. You have your simple electrical panel here. which controls the 12 volt and 24 volt stuff here. And then also we have the more complicated panel breaker switches behind here. Generator controls, inverter control here. We have our Vectron Energy battery monitoring system, our HRO remote switch, and our digital multi-controller here for the Vectron Energy controller as well. The 504 VHF, and then we also have a C120 widescreen GPS plotter here as well. The galley, really nice style galley. When you go with the aft master, you don't have another doorway going through here, so you have extra cabinet space here. You can see from the pictures, three burner stove and oven. We have a microwave that's conveniently located behind this cabinet, fridge, freezer. We have a custom ice maker down below the double stainless steel sinks here. The table itself has leaves on both sides that open up. These chairs will actually float, and so you can move them in different angles, but they do have lockdowns, or what a lot of my clients do is they'll just strap it around the table so you don't have any extra hardware in these beautiful upgraded teak floors. The bench itself, this will open up. You'll see from the pictures, there's a nice little storage bar under here. We have a very high-end satellite television system here, all HDTVs. We have the Bose V3 system, which has three speakers forward, and then also speakers in the aft with a subwoofer. Really nice high-end stereo television system here. This is really unique. So as you go up forward, I actually have the center divider wall. These are two different staterooms. So it also gives you the convertible option is if you wanted to have a separate master or a second master. What happens is there's a wall, you can see the groove. This wall breaks down, it's in seven pieces, and that gets stowed underneath the bed here. And then you can take the double bunk beds and fold this down. So you now have a couch, a little desk vanity area, and then a separate bed on this side. The other feature that it offers is when this door is closed and the wall is out, this piece lifts up as so, and there's a filler cushion, and it makes the bed much larger. So it is another true second VIP stateroom here. Then it has its own VIP head with electric quiet flush toilets, really nice high-end fixtures. There is a plexiglass doors that encapsulates the shower area, keeping the rest of the galley dry. And then you have the, if you know if the wall is in place, you have a separate head for this stateroom to port. And then all the way forward is the V-berth. So the V-berth is quite nice. We have hatches overhead, you know, that keep all of the UV out of this room. We have a flat screen television here, hanging locker, additional storage. So just a great area. Now you can convert this into a crew cabin, and then they would have their own head and shower here. You know, can lock this door or else keep it free flowing if you have a large family. So it's a really nice functional layout. Air conditioning, heating on all of the staterooms. Here is the control command center for the television system. Quite superb. We have the Bose, the Sirius satellite receivers, the additional receivers for each television, the KVH track system, main monitoring system here, and then a Samsung Blu-ray player. So lots of goodies. Walking back aft through the salon, you're going to see that we have a great access into the aft master. This is one spectacular stateroom. We have a queen size centrally located bed, lots of good headroom over the bed. Two large hatches on both sides that can also be used as escape hatches. The amount of storage is just remarkable. You have lower storage areas here. All of this is just one big cabinet with lots of storage. Your private head and shower. Once again, Japsco quiet flush toilets. Separate shower stall here with a really nice fixture. We have a plexiglass door that encapsulates this shower, keeping the rest of the head dry. And just a really nice, well done, well laid out master stateroom. Bench area, desk vanity, and a huge hanging locker. This hanging locker has two doors They're both louvered for good ventilation and offer you a great amount of storage. Well, I know this video was very short for the amount of items and systems that are found on this yacht, but please feel free to look through the listing. Call me at any time, day or night. I look forward to talking with you and discussing this vessel and your cruising plans. Thank you again. And once again, my number is 619-507-4416.